Okay, it's been too long since I did one of these. In fact, I'm mainly doing this because the C3 is back on SNW Central. They're having another creativity convention, and I just love to go and play a bunch of those submissions that get sent in there that people show off, trying to win awards, but sometimes just want this time to show off their works and be praised for doing so. I have absolutely nothing to showcase this C3. I don't even think I had anything to do so for the last. I mean, all I'm really doing is just doing these Let's Plays now. And I'm probably gonna see if I can get some non-SNW related content to the C3 Let's Play spree as well. And would you believe that I started doing this about 5 years ago? It's the main reason that no matter what, I just want to keep this going. Even though I'm probably so far out of the loop. Physicist was talking about the new Super Mario 2 demo of New Super Mario 2 Around the World is going to showcase levels from Worlds 9, 10, and 11, if I'm not mistaken. And I think he said something about it having 16 plus worlds, which is absolutely insane. So yes, this ROM pack is still a work in progress. Bint Gold Peach, you might also know him as GD, Gameplay's Death on the Dose, SNWC23105, that was his user ID. And the guy who ported pretty much a bunch of Crash Bandicoot tracks. Pretty much everything from Crash 1, Crash 2, and Crash 3. Three great games, so that was really welcome to see. Didn't even read the intro message. Probably wasn't supposed to. Okay, so I'm guessing Mario's house in the tutorial level is still there, just in case you don't know how to wall kick, or you need a refresher, which I really don't think I would. Right. Nice drawings along the walls. These pictures are pretty cute. Really didn't need the tutorial level again, but maybe someone missed the first demo. Let's go with the green gas swamp. Okay, I'm kind of noticing that up here with one of the trees right near the waterfall, the corner is purple and not blue, but it's really nothing major. Let's just see what the levels are actually about, more than anything else. So I'm guessing this is the haunted forest world? Or it's gonna be the ghost world. Okay, I really like what he did with the Layer 3 mist. That looks more. I mean, it was just one solid color and didn't really have too much shape to it in the original Super Mario World. I mean, here he enhanced it a bit. And it definitely makes it feel like a little more is going on now. Got a nice sky gradient and these clouds with the faces from the pumpkin plants on them. Wait, what is this? Oh, this is the gimmick. So how does this work? If I stay up here. Oh, I see. If I stay towards the top half of the level, then I'm not gonna die from being too close to the swamp. Yeah, I remember that the air meter was a thing. I just don't know exactly how he reprogrammed it so that it just depletes while you're on the bottom half of this level. Yeah, it's going back up when you're in the top half of the level. I think I'm stuck here. Actually, no, I can just wall kick to save myself. Just remembered I could wall kick. Haunted Mansion, alright. This is gonna have two exits or something. Or at the very least be cryptic and as be like one of those where do I go levels. Okay, that was a really dumb move. Nice palette, even like this little. little section here. Yeah, I just heard some music break. Or maybe that's part of the track itself. Wait, can you even grab these blocks? Actually, no, they just disappear when you jump off them. I can just get across here anyway, even if I made all those purple blocks disappear, because some more appear when you hit the switch. Thought I was gonna do some crazy spin jumping shenanigans for a second. Somehow end up at the midpoint anyway. Even though this door is hitting. Okay, I've never seen this one before. I've never seen a Boo do this before. This is news. Holy crap. And I just accidentally found a secret passage. And then another one that's actually just a dead end. So that leads up here. That leads into here. Okay, I just found the secret exit. Like we got it, including insta-kill water. And whatever that is shooting purple balls of energy, it's probably it looks like a seahorse. It's probably a seahorse. Just never thought I'd see it here of all places. Now you can actually go in this part of the water. So that one kills you too. I mean, the difference between the watercolors is very subtle, what else can I say? Okay, I don't think I've seen this part probably yet either. So I'm gonna go down here. Yeah, I'm probably dead. Okay, I need to swim upwards and I can't do that. I don't move very fast left or right. Going downwards is gonna get me killed and I can't go up because there's a ceiling there. Goal. So I literally just have to swim past this stuff and I'm on the level. Except it shoots the fireballs faster than I can even swim, so that's kind of a problem. I just really have to plan this out very carefully. I mean, I fall faster and swim upwards much faster than I do going sideways. I can't even see anything on the screen now. With that HDMI effect and everything. So I can just use that to my advantage. As it's about to shoot, just swim upwards or just drop downwards to avoid the fire. Oh, the sewer world. I really want to see what this was gonna look like, though. I guess we won't get to see it. Yeah, excuse me while I just get back to the second half of the Haunted Mansion, because, well, I need to get back there so I can go for the normal exit. Okay, I haven't been here before. There's coins everywhere, and there's booths shooting fire, so this is gonna be a really interesting room. Okay, I'll take it. Just a little bonus something, I guess. Hey, at least I got a power-up out of that. Okay, so I probably have to go in here anyway. So that door appears when you hit the switch, I guess. So that explains why I got it, like, first try. Now can I please get the midpoint again? Yeah, that took much longer than it should have. So yeah, go to the wall again, because that's where it's hidden. That's where I can find the real door. Alright, then now we're back here. So yeah, that's the opening in the wall that if I go through it, I get to the secret exit, so let's not do that this time. Now I just have to find my way to the normal exit eventually. Oh, not really nice palette here. Some really pale brown, like really saturated yellows with some greens and some spectral dark blues in the background. I mean, you can do a lot with colors that are next to each other on the color wheel if you know how to just mix them. Clearly did a really good job with that. Gonna work though. Oh, magic of lets me get through there. I mean, do different crystals breaking have different effects though or something? Why not just all turn blocks? I probably haven't figured out the gimmick yet. I don't think I've figured it out yet. Just becomes solid and just looks really ugly and blocks your view. Alright, 9-6, Blue Fire Castle. I'm gonna stop the video here once I'm done this level. World 10's gonna be in another one. Assuming that's Worlds 9 to 11 and not just Worlds 9 and 11. Freak me out that much anymore. Probably because there's just so much worse that can happen to you in these ROM hacks. Alright, I wall jump. Silly me. Forgot I could just do that. Oh, so that's why the flames are two different colors. I see. Gas bubbles and a fishing boat is gonna be fun. At least duck jumping is gonna reduce the size of my hitbox, so that should help a bit. Okay, that could have gone ugly. I am definitely not going for that dragon coin. Like, that fishing boot has like such a weird hitbox that I just don't want to go for the dragon coin. I kind of want to just stay at the bottom half of the screen as much as possible, because of that flame on the fishing hook there, that's really, really choppy. It's like the total opposite of smooth. It just feels so awkward. That's probably why it's just so hard to deal with in the first place. Plus a weird hitbox on top of that. Alright, so am I fighting with Fishing Boo, or am I gonna fight something else? boxes, actually. You have to grab some random sparkles throughout the level. Grab all three, and that just kills the fishing boat. Well, of course, you have to dodge them, because, well, then it wouldn't even be, like, any point. Then there wouldn't be challenge if you didn't have to dodge them. Pretty neat little boss. I can appreciate some interesting design here and there. Okay, so we'll tend the mountain. Let me just see what the rest of the world looks like again. Oh, there's the Swiss Hotel. There's our obligatory Swiss Hotel in World 2. There's the Mycelium Island. Here's your obligatory grass world. The Oriental world was here. That's the beach world down here. And some water. I really don't know what the 3 is for, though. Forest world. Autumn world, I think. I'm not sure what kind of world this is supposed to be. Those plants really aren't telling me much. Desert, city, we just went through the swamp world, the haunted world, and now we're on the mountain with the bullets. Hoping we don't have another rockfall world, I'm gonna be in deep trouble. Oh, Skyward looks nice. I mean, everything feels like it's now just kind of scrunched up into really small overworld maps. I mean, how else are you gonna fit 16 worlds with the one hack? Everything's probably just gonna end up feeling all really scrunched up and tiny. Like, this sky world doesn't get a lot of space at all. Nor this mountain. I mean, you still fit 5 levels of this for the looks of it, maybe 4.